Hello everyone. So basically, welcome back. Yes, that's the second part of Düsseldorf to Berlin with Cessna 208. So just a quick summary of what happened. Basically, the simulator crashed and for some reason it just didn't want to load out. It was yesterday. So what I did, right now we're in 13,000 feet, 106 knots, and we're exactly in the point where the simulator crashed yesterday. So nothing to worry there. So this will actually be the second part of the flight. So we will just, and what I did also, I clicked here for live weather and live time. So it will be interesting. I have to say that also the weather today, the live weather is, the clouds are amazing. So we will probably see. Basically, that's a real IFR now, as you can see, as you cannot see. This is exactly where it crashed yesterday. So now we will continue from here. I set up all the flight plan. I did everything again. So. And so now you can see. Here, exactly in the same spot on our way, and not soon in 40 minutes it will be the top of descent. So descent in around 40 minutes, sorry. Here, look at that, that's what I meant. That's live weather and live time.
Bremen Center KLM 136 is at flight level 360, descending 10,000 feet.
Cessna Charlie Delta Lima contact Bremen Center on 119.825. Good day. KLM 1366 Bremen Center, continue as planned.
Bremen Center, Cessna Charlie Delta Lima, say again.
Cessna Charlie Delta Lima, contact Bremen Center on 119.825. Good day.
119.825, Cessna Charlie Delta Lima. Bremen Center, Cessna Charlie Delta Lima, 13,000 feet.
Cessna Charlie Delta Lima, Bremen Center, altimeter 30.01, continue as planned.
Set up everything here, the speeds to minimum. Plans, map, everything set up. Now that's a radius of 2.5 miles, which means that if we fly, let's say 2.5 miles, and then let's say that we fly 120 knots, okay, it will take us in this circle 1 minute 25 to reach this area so we can make the range. Yeah, let's say 5. So 5 to 120. This radius is 2.5 minutes each direction. So we'll be here in 2.5 minutes, for example. What's happening outside? Or something. I don't know which view you prefer. I can do that way. And to put a small map over here that you'll see where we are. I feel like a passenger looking on your iPhone trying to see where we are. It's a nice view. Clouds. Of course, if you have any questions, or if you have any requests of flights or explanations, please let me. Something 13,000 feet. Give myself some coffee and cake here. Wonder if I can connect the camera to my Xbox as well. The camera.
125 decimal one. Good day.
Going to 125 decimal one air float 2606.
Clouds or something else. Makes the experience so much better. Thousand feet, and the clouds are it will be a bit of a bumpy ride now. I'm going to enter this area here. We will turn left. Yeah, let's see. See, those light will work. I would pick this now. You know how it goes with the default. Good. everything that happened is for the best, even though the elevator crashed yesterday, which gave us this weather today. Just how beautiful it is. Wow, just wow, look at that.
Cessna Charlie Delta Lima contact Berlin Center on 125.8. Good day.
Going to 125.8, Cessna Charlie Delta Lima. Berlin Center, Cessna Charlie Delta Lima, 13,000 feet.
Cessna Charlie Delta Lima, Berlin Center, altimeter 29.98, continue to Bureau as planned.
So the weather is 29.98. The altimeter is off. Now, as you can see here, that will be our top of descent. So we'll be there in 15 minutes, we'll start to descend. So 14 minutes of descent, so let's check everything. Start with opening the charts. We'll need to be 5,000 feet at over, and then we will intercept the glide slope on Idu, I think that's the name, of 4,000 feet, and it will be 12 nautical miles. 12 miles basically from the runway. The minimum for this one is 283, which is 290 feet. And if we miss approach, we go to 280 to Ogber and climb to 5,000 feet. That's basically it. Change that. Usually it remembers things, but I think I changed it. Alright, so we're getting close. That's the top of descent, which would be in 7 minutes and 50 seconds. And yeah, when we'll get close, we will click on VNAV, which will start to the descent basically. Now on ENR, it means that we're on the airway. It is here, airway 207, and that's will end in Hochberg, which is this one, 5000. Everything is set up. Now for the descent, the best speed will be 72 knots. This here because it's easier to look. This here for the approach. You can see here it's 5000, so we can start preparing. In order for it to go to 5000, we need to allow it to go to 5000, so we will need to set up the altitude to 5000. We can already do it 4000 because this will be the interception, the interaction with the glide slope. And then yeah, 10,000 feet, we will turn this one on and this one off. That's the cabin light that you see on our passengers reading books now and with their iPhones. This will be approximately our descent rate, 8 per minute, which is nice. 5 minutes, good, good. Already clicked the VNAV. You will see it will change here to VPATH. This will be the virtual basically speed that we will descend. Now it's above us. You will see slowly it will start going down and then. As you notice that I'm always changing the radio here, because here it's more difficult on this side. And if you will notice on the left side when I'm scrolling, it can only go down. Doesn't matter if I scroll up or down, that's a known bug for the G1000 NXY development team. They're working on it. Yeah, basically bad compared to all the benefits that we get here. Everything looks good. Three minutes. What I would like to do slowly, I sure if that's the right thing to do. I still need to read a little bit more about it, because until this day I just flew Cessna 172 in real life, and you don't have the RPM adjustment. And also in the Diamond aircraft, you have just a computer setup basically that's setting it up. So I need to learn about it. Minutes and 30 seconds. Let's see if there's nothing outside. Passengers. Well. Okay. Here we will start to descend. Starting to reduce. It will also make this around 500 at least. And when it will intercept, yeah, it did. So you see, it changed.
Cessna Charlie Delta Lima.
Descending. That's a good descent rate. Good. So basically, yes, I will, of course, I'm doing it right now. So, the charts of the airport. So as I mentioned in the other video, I have other videos that I show how I actually plan the flights for IFR. I'm using SimBrief, ChartFox, and SkyVector. They're all for free. In the US, SkyVector also offered airport plates or charts for free, so it's nice. Europe, you will want to use ChartFox or Navigraph. And yeah, that's basically how I do it. Just for ChartFox, you will need a VATSIM account, which is for free as well. So I will say, you can open one for free. And yeah, that's about it. That's our ideal descent rate. Descent speed, sorry. I see the fuel running out. Hopefully, we will make it. Right, 10,000 feet.
Please expedite your climb
13,000
feet.
Yes. Expediting right away. And right, we will start actually the star in 10 minutes. Outside minus 3 degrees Celsius.
Cessna Charlie Delta Lima, you are 47 miles west. Maintain present heading and altitude. Expect RNAV runway 07 left approach via Ogbur transition. Clear to Ogbur.
Maintain present heading and altitude. Expect RNAV runway 07 left approach via Ogbur transition. Clear to Ogbur Cessna Charlie Delta Lima.
Now she got it. That's an IFR flight, good.
Cessna Charlie Delta Lima, please expedite your climb 13,000 feet.
She didn't. Okay. Enter.
Charlie Delta Lima. Please expedite your climb 13,000 feet.
Sleeping on her.
The thing I'm worried about is the fuel, that it will be enough.
Cessna Charlie Delta Lima, please expedite your climb 13,000 feet.
Started to measure, so started the timer. Stopper, when it was 75.
It will reach 70, we'll see.
Very close to the stall. Around 5 minutes.
Cessna Charlie Delta Lima, please expedite your climb 13,000 feet.
5 minutes, so.
I hope we'll have enough. Next time I will I will put more fuel. Disadvantage with it that the air traffic controller will not understand it and will not sync between the G1000 and the air traffic controller, because technically that's how we should descend. If we will start our descent here, we will never make it. So yeah, I will try maybe to aisle 9. I checked, but now VATSIM is not supported with Xbox, and
Cessna Charlie Delta Lima.
At least when the G1000 when we will be able to modify the altitude here, then somehow it will be able, to work it out with the controller. That it will not be that annoying, but yeah. Pretty close to 5,000. 1 minute. Fuel is okay. Start this car. We're good.
Decimal 63 for Cessna Charlie Delta Lima. Bremen approach Cessna Charlie Delta Lima is at 5,000 feet, climbing 8,000 feet.
Cessna Charlie Delta Lima Bremen approach altimeter 29er decimal 9er 5, continue to DB 511 as planned.
think that's the airport. I think so. It should be. Keep an eye on the fuel. Kind of good with 11 minutes and we're there. Next waypoint. Under which river is this? Five.
And maintain 6,000 feet, Cessna Charlie Delta Lima.
Hope that the fuel will be enough. That's my only concern. New top of descent is here. I don't know if you can see. Top of descent to reach 4,000 here. So nice approach.
Charlie Delta Lima, keep speed not above 220 knots.
Not above 220 knots. Yes, yes.
Keep speed not above 220 knots, Cessna Charlie Delta Lima.
have several airports. So we will intercept here. 1,000 feet here. It's the runway. I think that's a small airstrip as well, not to be sure. Time to land, so
set everything up.
We will need 2,000. Good. So you see that's the glide slope. 23 in fuel, so we're good. Click approach. Then it will click here GP. It will show here GP and Alt V. So the hairs that I used. Good. We can close that. And when this verb, you know, diamond will be here, we need to be configured with flaps. So let's retract of flaps and we will add more. Another one. Let's save it. I don't know the glide speed on the Cessna 208, I still need to check it, so I will assume it's around 74. Okay. Checked online and the VX, the descent rate is 72, I guess it's around the same. Now I'm going to intercept this very soon. That's Berlin, somewhere there. So now you see it's GP, which means that we need the glide slope. So now it's LPV, that's our approach. And yeah, we're good to land. Approach altitude, which is 5,000, and the runway heading, and we can just click on back course. There we go. Our minimum is 290, but we can also can already see the runway, so no need for that. Just a bit of brightness. have the low fuel. Because, yeah, indeed, it's low. Remember, when it's balanced 2 and 2, you're good. Everything is red. There is this sentence, red is dead, so that in mind. Favor, as you can see here. Put on the glide slope. Everything looks so much nicer at night. Nice airport. Try to keep the autopilot till the minimum. Yeah, we're good here. Let's land. Disengage the autopilot. Increase the speed a bit. Wow, it's windy. Too high, so we need to reduce throttle. Just remember when you land. Okay, 1 second, I'll focus. Rough. Subs. I thought I activated the reverse throttle. Jeez. Here. Oops. What a rough landing it was. Sorry for that. The new reverse throttle is new to me. Let's check. If I click here, it's not working. Okay, so I need to click here, then maximum, then reduce. Okay, it's a bit weird, but anyway, let's clear the runway. Ground.
Parking. Berlin ground, Cessna Charlie Delta Lima request taxi to parking.
Cessna Charlie Delta Lima taxi to general aviation parking via taxiway Delta Bravo Alpha cross runway 25 right Echo Foxtrot.
Taxiing to general aviation parking via taxiway Delta Bravo Alpha cross runway 25 right Echo Foxtrot Cessna Charlie Delta Lima.
Have 2% of fuel. Landing was rough. That was a tough one. But always remember, it is a good landing if you can open the door, right? Going across the runway, but I'm not sure that They will. It's not working in the sim. Right. Anyway, let's finish up here. Because we ran out of fuel. That means exactly on time. Let's see. Ask for ground services. And that I asked. Parking. Very quickly. Oh, tomorrow it will be another episode of IFR around the world. We'll take off from Norway and we will continue our journey to the US. So, see how it goes. I don't think we'll make it in one leg, but we'll see. Big airport. This is so real. Here. So, thank you very much for watching, and hopefully we see you tomorrow, IFR around the world.